Rescue has turned to recovery in the US city of Baltimore, with six people presumed dead after a cargo ship crashed into a major bridge, causing it to collapse. The vessel losing power minutes before impact, with initial reports suggesting it was a tragic accident. The disaster, though, could have been much worse, as US correspondent Logan Church reports.
This camera, capturing the moments the container ship Dali struck Francis Scott Key Bridge in Baltimore.
Yo!
In seconds, the 2.5 kilometer long structure collapsing into the sea.
The whole bridge just fell down. Everybody. The whole bridge just collapsed.
And within minutes, a frantic search for 8 construction workers who were on the bridge. 2 were pulled from the water, 1 severely injured, 1 unhurt. Hope is fading, though, for the rest as body recovery starts.
This is a tragedy.
The huge 300-meter vessel left Baltimore's port about 12:30 at night. But as it approached the bridge about an hour later, a total power blackout with the loss of control and propulsion. Then lights flicker on and off, and thick smoke rises from the ship. Right after power was lost, a mayday call was issued and the anchors dropped, but it was too late. At 1:28, you can see the last cars leaving the bridge. 30 seconds later, collision. Officials say the ship was moving at 8 knots, faster than it should have been with a local pilot driving it. The incident, an economic disaster too, severing sea access to one of the busiest ports in America. The entire east coast of the United States now has a shipping nightmare on its hands, with the port of Baltimore closed to all incoming container ships. While shipping companies are racing to find other ports, big delays are expected.
But the main thing they got to do right now is get that shipping channel open, because you're going to punish Baltimore.
It's a little scary, especially not knowing when the next time they're going to open it up, when the next time you're going to get a job.
The U.S. president pledging taxpayer funds to rebuild.
We're going to send all the federal resources they need as we respond to this emergency. I mean all the federal resources. And we're going to rebuild that port together.
First responders thankful the disaster wasn't worse. There was little traffic on the bridge at the time, and the mayday call allowing police to shut the bridge access roads. Preliminary reports say this was most likely an accident, but still one of America's worst maritime disasters in recent years. Logan Church, One News, New York.